Well, if you're on my Instagram, you heard all this, I guess, big-ish news earlier. You should all be on my Instagram, by the way. Last Humans Garage. But I am going to go through a slow part out here. Now, there is something visibly missing from this engine compartment already. I wouldn't expect many people to notice, but just people that have been around me a long time might be able to spot a very obvious mod that is missing. The IAG AOS can, which was in that corner. Whew, that is a beast to remove, let me tell you. So I am going to be having a few raffles here and there coming up. Now, this is a long process, by the way. Oh, let me get the fluid dampener instructions. This is not like it's a month and we're done. The tune is the biggest problem with this D-mod, and don't bother asking me, what am I getting next, all that crap. I post about that and make videos about that every week, so just watch them and you'll know the answers if you're interested. All right, so yeah, I got the whole AOS out for now. And as you saw, the two pulleys are out. That's a later video. We're not doing that right now. And luckily the car works fine. Oh, what I was talking about, a longer term D part out. Because the tune is very tricky on this. A lot of these mods are tune related. So I have to be very calculated each time I downgrade. See that pipe that didn't used to be there? Each time I downgrade, that's removed with the AOS install. Each time I downgrade, I have to make sure that there's a viable tune flavor for this and make sure that I can run it safely, right? So the first thing was easy. Neither the pulleys or the AOS, which I'm going to show you in a minute, require a tune. So that's the first obvious step. Next will be phases. And I want to use up all my ethanol. Yeah, I'll miss it, but there's bigger pastures out there for me. Use up all my ethanol. Just transition straight to 93. Then, when I'm fully on 93, remove that flex fuel kit. Will be another item that'll be going out. And it's a lot simpler than it looks, I think. That's just the sensor and the O2 harness. There's not a whole lot with that thing at all. So, and at that point, I'll take off the tune that has the flex fuel tune. And then it was our stage two with EGR and TGV deletes tune would be the next stage after flex fuel is removed. Then when it really gets nutty, I may have a stage two without TGV and EGR, but I can't remember. If that's the case, I do those two next. If that's not the case, I'd have to do all the stage two in a day and use one of my many, many stage one tunes at that point. Anyway, let's get to the first part out raffle piece of this new exciting journey we're going to. This is our IAG air oil separator. Everybody knows about this piece. And I did a little labeling for you to help you understand the piece. Now I have some directions. Now it is not full by any means. I think I'm missing the first 15 pages, which are easy anyway. For what I probably threw them out because I didn't need them. But I think from page like 15, 16 on, I have directions here, although you probably want to go online to get clearer pics of all this. And it's a tough install. I'm not going to lie. It's a tough install. Pain in the butt. As everybody that has done it will tell you. But I can show you what we got here from this side over. Now, these hoses look very intimidating, but they're not as intimidating as it seems once you look at it. This piece right here. This is your big air line at the turbo. Remember that piece we just saw across the top of the engine, that plastic pipe? This is where that goes, to where the bottom of that pipe, that pipe goes down to toward the turbo. This is what connects there, this piece. And you say, well, what connects to the other half of that plastic piece on the top plastic pipe on the top of the engine. Well, that would be right here, the intake port, front of engine, under intake. So we took care of that, and we took care of that, right? These two. Now we can do these other three sections. This is pretty obvious here. Coolant in and coolant out. This one, you remove a coolant hose right from your turbo in the front. It's pretty easy to get to. And you put this piece where the turbo hose was removed, and you swing that turbo hose you disconnected, loosen the clamp to turn it so the bend changes, and you point it up instead of down, and it taps in right here. So that completes the coolant chain. So now we've got the air tube, the other air tube, and the coolant. All we got left is what's in the middle. See, it looks a lot simpler when you really think about it like this, doesn't it? Now, instead, you take out your PVC valve for this, and you put in this straight through piece, right? So keep that in mind. This doubled up hose here with the V goes to the new PCV valve, which isn't a PCV valve at all. That's what I was saying. Then when you pull off that hose off of your real PVC valve, your original hose, to old PVC valve hose, you stick that hose right on here. And that's all there is. When you look at it like this, it really does not seem as crazy. As it even made it seem simple to me as you label each piece. Now the other things this unit will come with in the raffle, of course you do get your PVC piece. I don't think you need this clamp, but since it was in my pack, I'm gonna just leave it anyway. This is your ECU remount bracket. That's probably one of the most pain things, I guess, relocating your ECU a little bit out of that corner. I believe you locate it down more to make room for that IAG in the corner. So that's a little tricky, but you know, there's directions for all of it, of course. A lot of people have done this. But this is your new ECU bracket that you'll use. This is a little bonus piece. See, if you want to run a track config instead of a street config, this piece bolts. Where does it bolt? I think it bolts on top. That's funny. I don't even know. Do those holes line up? Well, yeah. That is where they go. I forgot. Under this piece here, just so you know, there's a whole ring of threads, tons of different positions you can choose, and you can angle this any way you want. That is why this piece works. You use two of those threads, and you angle it in the correct direction, and what this will do is, this is a dump straight out to the ground with no recirculation. Not that good for ethanol cars. That's why I use the triple. But conceivably, you could remove these three hoses of mess and just have one little hose right there, would totally simplify things. So this is included. This did not come with it originally. This is all included as a bonus, so you can have a choice of street or track as you study your setup and spend many weeks preparing for this install. I think these Allens might have come with it, so I'll just throw them in. And lastly, this install in the ECU uses a lot of your stock bolts. So that's why there's only a couple here. These are for the new ECU, which will go through your ECU and you, like with factory nuts, because it's held on with the factory nuts. You use those to finish this connection. And I think these two came with it. I'm not positive, but I am going to include them, because you might need them. Two more 10 millimeters right there. You know these are not factory, because factory doesn't have a Phillips head in the head there. It doesn't have a Phillips spot. So that is the IAG AOS raffle. I'm gonna put up the Facebook raffle today. When you're watching this, I'm gonna be working on it, get it up there. I think I'm gonna do $20 a ticket on this. This is a pretty heavy value item. $20 a ticket, probably a minimum 10 entries required. I don't think that'll be a problem, just to make sure that it's at least covered a little bit. and hopefully a little more turnout than that. And this is all toward my new car fund, to see how close I can get to the next car for this channel. So good luck with that. I'll put this up. I'm gonna start boxing and cleaning this up a little bit, and there will be a lot of videos. It may not be the kind of videos you like. This will be all removal videos and news updates videos on the new stuff. Anyway, thanks for staying tuned. Hopefully it'll get exciting with something new later. But if you're just a Subaru guy and you don't like anything but Subarus, hey, at least you have my 941 videos to refer to if you need any help with any of your mods or parts. Last Humans Garage, signing out.